We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, must establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and to our posterity. Do ordain and establish this Constitution to the United States of America. My name is Yemanya Carey, and I'm an evolutionary change agent, a master healer, spiritual teacher, mother, daughter, sister, auntie, and friend. And I have to give thanks to my fifth grade teacher who, you know, at the time it seemed horrible, but we got the assignment to memorize the preamble to the Constitution. And it's been interesting because I've had the opportunity to deeply reflect upon the words that are spoken in this Constitution. And it's we, the people, not the government, not Monsanto's, not Big Pharma. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, this is what we're going for here. This is what our forefathers wanted. Except for right now, I sit and I'm a little bit sad about the state of our union and the separation that I'm witnessing. So I'm bringing you a talk on unity. I had the opportunity of going to Standing Rock. I was there about 3.5 weeks ago. It was with a project called Woman of Light, Feed the Tribes. We were also filming a documentary. We brought $20,000 worth of healthy food to the nations up there. We donated them to all the camps, all the camps where the food is. And we also were able to set up a healing tent. So we were a group of 16 healers. We set up a tent, we brought in vitamins and supplements, and now it is now a continuous on-stream going healing tent that works in conjunction with the medic tent for all of the water protectors that are out there holding the line for us.
Yeah. Woo!
While I was there, it was probably one of the most life-changing experiences. Left me with a lot to think about and a lot to feel about. But one of the greatest privileges I had was to walk around with people and talk with the elders. And one of the elders that I met with, his name was Sunny, and he told me, there are two things that we have to find within ourselves that will help us beat the black snake. Two things, and each person will have an individual two things, but there are two things that will help us beat the black snake. And I sat with that because I felt pretty curious about that, merely because an elder that I had spoken with the day previously, who is a dream keeper, her name is Patricia, told me that she was just sharing, this guy just shared with her about how he had a vision or a dream about two things that would help stop the black snake. And in his vision, it was the buffalo and the wolf. And in his vision, these buffaloes came down over the fields and down, and they stopped the black snake. And then a pack of wolves came from around and they stopped at a black snake. And then they started forming a circle, the unified field of a circle running in a circle to stop and hold the black snake from moving any further. So when I get home, a few days later, I see a news feed on Facebook, and I see those bison coming down the mountain. Have you guys seen that thing?
Yeah.
I was ecstatic. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is the vision. This is the prophecy. It's starting to happen. The animal kingdom is hearing the prayers. It's going to happen. Now all we need is the wolf pack. We need the wolf pack to come. Back home, and I was talking. talking with an elder here from a local tribe, and I was telling him the story about the vision, the message, the bison. And I said, now all we need is the wolf pack. And he goes, you know, we actually call the people the wolf pack. And I said, maybe the wolf pack is already there. And I started to think about that. I said, maybe the wolf pack is already there. So what is the wolf pack? What is the... I was like, maybe it's not the physical animal. Maybe it's the embodiment of the medicine of the wolf that we need to understand, that we need to like cultivate and become a part of, so that we can not only assist the water protectors, but assist ourselves and the larger community to become back into that union, into that wholeness. Yeah. So this is what I came up with. Three things. One, family. The wolf is all about family. They have one mate, they have babies, there's a little family unit, and then more family units, and they come together as a herd or as a pack. They're a large family. I witnessed this when I was at Sandy Rock. It was family. It didn't matter what color, what religion, what belief system you came from, everybody was a brother, a sister, an auntie, an uncle, an elder, a child. We were one family working towards a unified goal. Family. They were there when we needed help, unloading the boxes. People we didn't even know would show up and just help move the boxes. And what we also learned was that many hands make life work. Family. That's number one. Number two, freedom. The wolf is all symbolic about freedom, as well as being a free spirit. Freedom, the foundation of our country. But with freedom comes great responsibility. The responsibility to walk lightly on the earth. The responsibility to make right relations with yourself so that you can make right relations with other people. The responsibility to find the forgiveness and compassion for those who may not necessarily hold the same opinion as you. Responsibility and the freedom that comes when we release those old belief systems and problems. Freedom. Number three, intuition, instinct. The wolf pack moves under instinct. We need to move from our head and back into our hearts. And in that place is where we can find the answers. In that place is where we can hear that guidance that moves us towards where we need to be going. But we have to get quiet. We have to listen to the great spirit that moves through us. We have to trust the intuition that comes through us and then feel it in our heart and use that as our birthplace to move forward in all of our actions. Three, trusting intuition. So I'm going to take you through a quick practice today so that we can become the wolf pack. So if you can, place your feet at one moment. Place your hand on your hearts, if that helps you bring attention to the heart space. And I want you to just take some deep breaths in and out. Bringing your body back into this room completely and just allowing everything else to just slip away, fall away. Breathing deep, deep, deep into the heart. The heart has an electromagnetic field that is 60 times stronger than the mind field. This electromagnetic field formed in two torus actually exceeds beyond our body 3 to 6 feet. Deep breath into the heart. Feel a warm golden glow starting to permeate the warmth. And then from the internal proprioception, tune into the toroidal field of energy that is now emanating from your body and touching the person next to you. So your field of heart is actually merging and blending with the people in front of you and the people behind you. The heart, the place where we find our divine purpose, the heart where we find our divine passion, the heart where there is love, joy, freedom, family. Ourselves and for all of humanity. Can I get a wolf pack?